Coming up on Pierce County News.
It could be 3 to 5 minutes, depending on where you're located.
How to prepare for an earthquake. The planning department goes paperless, and Puyallup unveils new art at City Hall. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. It's not something most of us think about every day or even every week, but experts say we should be thinking about and planning for a major earthquake right now. Sabrina Register reports on how Pierce County Emergency Management can help you get ready for the big one.
It's something children learn and practice on a routine basis in school. Drop, cover, and hold on. It helps keep you safe in an earthquake. Historically, the Northwest experiences lots of small quakes, not major ones, that cause widespread devastation and injury. But experts caution that a major earthquake will strike our area, maybe next month, or maybe not for 100 years, but say it's going to happen.
That quake we had back in 2001, it was a 6.7, and it was a deep quake. Expect that level of shaking and intensity, but it will be longer. It could be 3 to 5 minutes, depending on where you're located.
An article in the New Yorker magazine last year talked about the big one coming, a 9.0 magnitude earthquake striking our region. So Pierce County decided to hold a series of workshops in March to address what the experts say and how to prepare for a major earthquake.
The workshops will have a special focus on disaster preparedness for vulnerable populations. Nicole Johnson with the Pierce County Office of Emergency Management says there's a lot to think about, especially when it comes to the elderly and people with disabilities.
Yes, you need food and yes, you need water, but there are so many other considerations that people have that they don't necessarily think about are going to be impacted by a disaster. For example, individuals who are maybe power dependent. If they lose power for 3 days, they may be okay. If they lose power for a week or 2 weeks, what does that look like?
Having a family plan and a list of out-of-town contacts from east of the Cascades, where the risk of a major earthquake is less, will prepare for when, not if, that day comes.
We're in the window, and that's important for people to know. So in the window is the time to get ready.
Sabrina Register, Pierce County News.
Pierce County will hold 6 workshops about planning for and surviving a big earthquake. They'll be held March 14th through the 19th at various locations countywide. The 1-hour presentations are free and no RSVP is needed. Hear from officials from Emergency Management and Community Connections. Well, we hear all the time that we should prepare for an earthquake, but what does that really mean? Joining me today is Roxanne Castleman. She is with the Department of Emergency Management with Pierce County. Roxanne, when we think about an emergency, how long should our family be thinking that we might be on our own?
Sure. If you are caught in an emergency in your vehicle, we recommend having a 3-day supply in your car. If you are caught in an emergency while you're at home, we recommend a 7 to 10 day supply for your home kit.
And so when you talk about the supply for the car and the home kit, and then where we should store some of that stuff at home, take me through some of those things we should be thinking about.
Sure. It could include food and water. Medication is one that people often forget. Weather radios, which is a big source of getting information through that disaster. Other things that you might consider, pictures of your family, animals, and animal care needs as well.
Okay, what about people with medical needs?
Sure, medical needs, it depends on what you use what you experience with your medical condition. If you have a device that is dependent on electricity, what does your plan look like for that? Is that plan including somebody who might need to take you to an alternate location that has electricity to support that device? Or do you have medication that you might need, extra medication you might need? Does that device depend on a generator? Do you need more fuel for that generator? Those are some questions you might ask yourself.
And what are some things that people, necessity type things that we just don't really think about sometimes?
Sure, great question. Again, back to the fuel for a generator, extra fuel. Other people might not consider the fact that you may not have communication through that emergency. So does your family already know that plan before the emergency hits in the event that you may not have communication for a couple of days?
Good points. And I know that a lot of this is on your website as well.
Yes, it is.
All right, thanks for coming in today.
Thank you.
Results are coming in from the February 9th special election in Pierce County, where 11 school districts had levy and bond measures on the ballot. Here's a list of all the school districts on the special election ballot. To see the latest results, visit the Pierce County Elections website. This election will be certified on February 19th. In rural parts of Pierce County, it's currently illegal to discharge firearms, but a proposal to remove the firearms ban in the Graham-Kapowsin area is moving out of committee and onto the full council. Council member Jim McCune is calling for an ordinance to remove the gun restriction on about 2,000 acres in his district. An amendment by council member Connie Ladenburg to create a 2/3 mile buffer around Kapowsin Elementary failed in the Public Safety and Human Services Committee. During public comment, one resident who lives in the affected area said most people use their guns for hunting or to control the coyote population, which preys on farm animals and pets.
It's not the wild, wild west out there. It's really not. There's very few people that do shoot. And when people are going, even on myself, when there's a lot of shooting going on, I would drive down and check it out because I'm like, well, what's going on? Because that's not normal for our area. We do a little, there's a little bit of duck hunting that goes on, and the rest of it's all predator control. Yeah.
The full council will vote on McEwen's proposal to remove the gun restriction on February 16th. The next time you need a building permit in unincorporated Pierce County, there's a new way to submit the paperwork. Megan Hatton is here to explain what this means for property owners and developers.
Heather, the county's planning department is going paperless, and that means it's a radical shift in staff saying goodbye to 7 copies of each page and hello to online submittals.
The days of finding shelf space for rolls of architectural drawings are coming to an end, and stacks of paperwork for building permits will be a thing of the past. Pierce County Planning and Land Services will go paperless on February 29th. Now all submittals will be done online or on a jump drive.
This is about not having to come in. Basically, we love to see you here. We love to answer questions. We love to help you with your project. But when you're getting to the submittal part, all of it can be done online, or they can come and just bring in the disc and move on.
Hanberg admits there are some times when printing is still necessary, but everyone in the office knows those are exceptions.
Well, a good example would be when maybe you had a big set of plans like this, and instead of getting the whole plan set printed, what we would do is just print maybe the one or two that are real key to what your review is.
Mostly gone are the days of spreading large plans out on a desk. Plans examiner Dan Woodard now does his job by computer, and Hamburg says customers like the faster response.
When you're reviewing these projects, we've got some great software behind it where we can more instantaneously respond to the client. Basically, we do the markups electronically, we email them, we usually get responses right back, and so this transaction all happens electronic rather than sending letters back and forth.
Did you have room on your worksheet for an option?
The department started going electronic last year, and many customers find the online process more convenient. But if scanning or submitting online is difficult for you, PAL staff can still handle your paperwork documents in person at the Pierce County Annex.
What we're able to do is take their material still in paper format, we scan it at the counter, give them back the paper, and get them into the system that way.
The forms needed for a building permit haven't changed, but how the public interacts with this process is the future of customer service at the county's planning department.
For now, Planning and Land Services is only requiring electronic copies at the time of initial application as customers get used to the new format. And Heather, it's important to note that going paperless doesn't prevent you from having to still do all the steps in the permit process.
All right, thanks, Megan. While the calendar still says winter, an art exhibit at Puyallup City Hall pays homage to spring and the city's famous flower, the daffodil. During the month of February, the city is showcasing the work of 26-year-old Anna Laura Castema at the City Gallery, located on the 5th floor of Puyallup City Hall. Castema is a third-generation Puyallup community member and wanted to explore the notion of beauty in the women who represented the city as Daffodil Queen.
She researched the Daffodil Festival going back a number of years, back to the 1930s, and she came up with photos of Daffodil Queens from Puyallup and Sumner High Schools. And then she took them and she painted with acrylic paint on pieces of cedar and different pieces of wood.
The artist says she didn't replicate the original photos. Instead, she embraced her role as painter and added her own impressions of each queen to make each one original. The Daffodil Festival started back in 1934 as a community event to celebrate the daffodil industry and arrival of spring. At one time, Pierce County was the largest producer of daffodil bulbs in the world. You can see Castema's artwork for free Monday through Friday from 8 until 5 through the month of February. Coming up next, see which city is making a splash with its new aquatic department. We're back in just 60 seconds.
Every day across America, excess food is gathered by a network of good people at local food banks, giving hope to millions of children who struggle with hunger. They've earned their wings, and you can too. Together, we can solve child hunger. Support Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
Now you can see Pierce County from your phone or tablet with the new PCTV mobile app. Pierce County and City Council meetings, the weekly Pierce County News
on PCTV,
news magazine Rainier Country, the topical discussions of Pierce County Talks, and all of the special programs in between. Download the app today and see Pierce County from here. PCTV, Pierce County Television. If you've been to the Fife Swim Center lately, you know swimming is fast becoming a big draw in Fife, where the city is changing how they operate and manage their public swim program. It's a busy late afternoon at the Fife Swim Center. Swimming lessons are underway and the swim team is also practicing. The pool used to be managed under the Parks and Recreation Department, but now it will be the Aquatic Services Department.
The decision was made to break the Aquatic Center off from Parks and Rec and to form our own division. And that not only helps us to grow our programs better, but it also allows for the accounting purposes to see how much, you know, money are we spending here and how much are we bringing in.
The aquatic program sees about 12,000 kids a year, and the average number of kids they see each week doubles in the summer.
We have a swim team here that's here 6 days a week. We run lessons currently 5 days a week. And then on top of that, there's water aerobics, mom and me, parent-taught swim classes, things like that.
February through August are the busiest months for the pool. Up next, a fun sport at Sprinker that doesn't require ice skates. But first, here's some dates for your calendar. Good dental hygiene is always important, but for those over the age of 50, caring for those pearly whites can present unique challenges. Changes in diet and metabolism, increased use of medication, and medical conditions can affect your teeth. Free one-hour workshops on caring for your teeth after 50 take place February 17th through the 19th at three locations in Tacoma. No RSVP is needed. If you're into aviation, don't miss the Northwest Aviation Conference and Trade Show on February 20th and 21st. It's at the Washington State Event Center in Puyallup, where more than 10,000 people will come to see aviation exhibits, seminars, and speakers. All-day admission is $5. Youth 17 and under get in free, and parking is free. This week, Mark Richards has a fun idea for where to hold your next group event. Hi, Mark.
Hi, Heather. Here at Sprinker Recreation Center, we understand not everyone knows how to skate. We have lessons for that, but if that's still not your thing, Broomball might be what you're looking for.
Broomball is similar to ice hockey, but instead of wearing skates, you play the game in your tennis shoes on the ice. You also hit a rubber ball with custom brooms instead of hitting a puck with a hockey stick. And you and your friends can rent out Sprinker for a special Broomball-only session. Broomball private rentals are offered from 10 p.m. on Fridays and Saturday nights and can include up to 30 friends. The cost is $250 and makes a great work or church party event. Call 253-798-4030 for more information. How does some traditional Southern cooking sound? Pierce County Parks and Recreation is offering the perfect class for you. Learn how to cook 8 Southern dishes when you sign up for this traditional deep-fried Southern cooking class. It will be held on February 19th from 6:30 to 9:30 at the Chambers Bay Environmental Services Building. The cost is $59 plus a $17 lab fee paid to the instructor. You can sign up now online. You can learn more about these activities and many more by checking out our new spring program guide. It's available online or in person. I'm Mark Richards from Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
I've never tried that, but it does look like a lot of fun. Thanks, Mark. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. For more local focus, download the PCTV mobile app for a quick and convenient way to watch Pierce County News on the go. Get the details at piercecountytv.org. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.